defining the problem. And that is very, very true. So guys, troubleshooting, you have to spend time. I used to build computers 25, 30 years ago, and I used to literally work for 2 or 3 days to figure out problems. But that's what it is, and that is how I learned. So guys, let me show you something. Let's say chapter 4 you are doing, let's say. Okay? And you are stuck, things are not working. Chapter 3, 4, 5, your final exam and midterm is not going to go well. Trust me. If you are lucky, you'll get a B grade. Otherwise, you may not even get that. You have to, and when you are defining dimensions, do one at a time. Deploy it, see it is working. If a dimension is not working, especially in your exam, do not expect to trouble soon. You can quickly find problem in 5 minutes, do it, but most likely you won't. Then just delete the dimension and start from scratch. That is a lot faster. We will discuss that. That I haven't decided yet. Okay, we are in now. Don't update anything, guys. When you get update message, just escape it. Okay? Don't update anything, just escape it or exit. Okay. Now let me show you. Let's say you want to start chapter 4 all over again, okay? What do?
You will copy the file that you have in our folder.
Yeah, I'll explain, just wait. First thing you want to do is this. You want to go to Management Studio, okay? This is how you clean up the machine, okay? You go to Management Studio, that is step number one. And there is a database which is not relational database. Don't touch that because that is your data source. But multi-dimensional database, get rid of it. When you deploy it, it will get recreated. You can leave it also, but I want to clean it up. You can leave it, it will be overwritten. But the clean way to do it is to just get rid of it. Let me show you what to do. And please use the directory structure that I am using in the class exactly the same way. It will be easier for me. If everybody does things differently, it will take me a very long time. It's a very large class. Now go to Analysis Services. Click on Connect. Okay? Now there will be, this is a multi-dimensional database. What is this problem?
Services are down.
It should be automatic. It is running.
But maybe
these services are running. So that is not a problem. Let me connect to, what did you say? Let me connect to database engine first. That is the machine name, I suppose. So database is working fine. This is the source, okay? And you have to have your database attached. If database is not attached here, you won't be able to do anything because they work together, okay? So this is working. Now you can connect to multiple instances. I can connect to analysis services also, okay?
Yeah.
It's working. What do you think was the problem? Guess it. The service was in the process of coming up probably. It was not fully initialized. Now it's working, previously it was not. So probably it was not fully initialized. Anyway, this database is multidimensional. This is the one that contains our cubes, our dimensions, everything. Okay? And you can see it, I'll show it to you. Guys, one more thing here, just so you know, I got some emails. It's a huge area, okay? It's very, very big. There is something called MDX, Multidimensional Expressor. That is the query language for cubes. Like SQL is the query language for relational databases, am I right?
Yeah.
MDX is the query language for cubes. I cannot make you expert in MDX. I'm not an expert in MDX, okay? I will show it to you so you get a feel of it. But if you really want to work in this area, 2-3 years down the road, or now when if you have time, get a book. There is another book available called Microsoft SQL Server 2008 MDX Step by Step. Like your book, just go step by step and you will learn MDX. I'll give you an example down the road this week and next week, but I don't expect you to become an expert. I will not ask you in your test to write an MDX expressor. I will not do that. That requires learning and we don't have time for that. I may ask you a question like, you know, MDX can be used, SQL can be used to query cubes. That's wrong, false. MDX can be used to query cubes, true. That kind of thing, okay? I won't ask you to write the expression. Same thing, browser is for the end user Excel. And we will look at that today or next week, okay? It is nothing but pivot table, you will see that. But again, I don't expect you to become an expert in pivot table. That is Excel course. It is very easy, I will show you the basics. I am not going to ask you in test any involved questions on pivot table, okay? Because our objective is to become expert in cube design. That's what we are trying to do. Okay? Okay, so I'm going to delete this, okay? Delete. Don't delete the source. Delete the multidimensional. That is one thing to clean up. Second thing you do to clean up is this. No, you don't do that. Don't do that. Just watch. And guys, help each other, work together, work with each other. That is how we used to study too. Now, this is where our databases are. And this is where we are working, okay? Now we have chapter 4. Now, what I will do is I'll delete this completely. Okay? I'll delete chapter 4. And now, as I told you, and I'm repeating it again, it is very important. When you start chapter 4, you are starting at the point where chapter 3 ended. And if you see what I gave you here, chapter 4 is really the starting point for chapter 4. Means chapter 3 ended. In chapter 4, you use that. The reason it is done this way is, if you had done things differently in chapter 3, it will be difficult for you to follow along with me. So we all want to do it exactly the same way. So we'll start with this. And if you have a problem with chapter 4, this is the end state of chapter 4. This is how it should look at the end. So this is the answer. Okay? So what you do now is this, if you want to start with chapter 4, take this, copy it, and go to our lab where we are working. This guy, paste. And now, you can open this guy. This is the solution. And the first thing you do is what? If you are starting chapter 4, what is the first thing you do? Open it and deploy it.
Yeah.
If deployment doesn't work, then you are working with bogus file, corrupt file or whatever. Do you see my point?
Yeah.
Then anything you do will be meaningless. Deploy it frequently, as frequently as you want to. Because if you deploy it frequently and you have a problem between last deployment and this deployment, you have done only a couple of things and you know where the problem is. But if you do entire chapter 3, chapter 4, and then deploy, now you'll have a hard time figuring out where the problem is. Don't forget, every dimension has a number of attributes. Every attribute has two levels, all and select distinct. And then you have user-defined hierarchies. Then you have relationships between attributes, okay? So there's a lot involved, and each one of those have properties. Some of them have 20 properties, others have 30 properties. And trying to figure out where the problem is, unless your error message is very, very obvious, is like looking for a needle in a haystack. And that is why do two, three things and deploy. Okay? This is how you work.
When we deploy the project, it's included the saving? The saving, it's included in the deploying, or we need to save and deploy? Or
first you should save. What does save do? Is save all the work that you have done. And those are all XML files, okay? Mm-hmm. Those are on your machine. And what does deployment do? Tell me.
Upload all the changes that
deployment will take your design, which is XML files.
It's compiling.
And it will upload it, it compiles it. Build is compiling. See, deployment is two steps. Build
and compile.
And upload. Okay? So it will compile it, it will take those files, compile them, and put them into analysis services database. Okay? Now guys, let me tell you, your midterm, multiple choice, true false questions, quizzes, they are very simple things. I am going to ask you to design a very, very simple cube with two dimensions and one measure only for your midterm, and slightly more complicated for the final. And that will carry a lot of points. In the midterm, probably it will carry 10 points. In the final, it might carry 20 points. And if you don't know how to do that, you will not be able to get even a B. Okay? So you have got to learn it. And keep on trying. Most of the time, I am home. If you need to work with me, you want to come to my home, you are welcome to. You have to set up a time with me. And you can work for the whole day there. I'll just charge you for lunch and dinner. That's I'm just kidding. So, you know, you can come over and I'll help you. That's the most I can do. For me to come to city is not practical for everybody. If you can do chapter 3, 4, 5, repeat it twice if you have to, then I am positive you will have no problem in your midterm and final. Another thing, your next quiz is on 14th of November, am I right? And midterm is also on 14th of November, I am going to change that. I don't want to give both tests at the same time. What I want you to learn is how to design cubes. That is my focus. I don't care about MDX. I'll give you a feel of it. I don't care about pivot tables. But designing cube is the key thing. Now your quiz number 2 is on 14. It will be the same thing, 12 true false questions, half point each. But this time I will give you multiple attempts like last time, but I will not pick up the best answer, because that way you can beat the system. I gave that to you last time only for practice, okay? This time you can attempt a question 10 times if you want. You'll have a choice. But it will pick your answer, the last one, whether it is right or wrong, not the best one. See, there are two answers, true and false, am I right? So you can attempt the question once true, once false, and if I picked up the best answer, then you'll get the full point. So this time, I'm going to do what I'm going to do in future. That is, you can attempt as many times as you want, but your last answer is the one that will be picked. Okay? In midterm, I have not planned everything, but I'm going to change your midterm from 11-14. I don't want to give it at the same time. I'll change the date. It will be probably right after Thanksgiving. Okay, probably 28 or so. 14, 21, 28, yes. So your midterm will be 28. That way, you know, we are spreading it out. And you have Thanksgiving to get some practice. And I'm going to give you a simple, very, very simple database. I'm designing it right now. It will be an extremely simple database with probably 3 tables: product, customer, and sales. Okay? And it will probably also have a date table, date dimension, because you may have a hard time designing that. And I will ask you to create a cube and dimensions. Product dimension, customer dimension, and a cube. And it's going to be extremely simple. It will not be even 1/10 of what you are seeing today here. It will have only a few attributes in the customer table, few attributes in the product table. There will not be any categories or subcategories, and few attributes on the sales table. Okay? And you will have plenty of time. I'm going to give you plenty of time. If you do everything right, designing that cube should not take you more than half an hour. I'll give you over 1 hour. That way, and the best thing is, if you have a problem, create a dimension first, upload and see if it is working. Create second one, upload and see if it is working. Because if it is not working, you don't want to move. And then create your cube and see if it is working. And if it is not working, delete it. And then start all over again. That's easier. So I'm not going to copy chapter 4 now, but I'm going to copy chapter 5, okay? Because chapter 4 is same approach. We are going to start with chapter 5. So this chapter 5 is the beginning of chapter 5, not the end of chapter 5. And this is the work that you have already done, okay? So I'm going to copy chapter 5, copy, and I'm going to paste it here in my class. Can you tell me, why am I not using from there but copying it here? Because I don't want to touch original.
They are, yeah.
I don't want to touch the original, just in case I have to start all over. So I have done that, okay? Now chapter 5, if you see, it has solution there. So now I am going to start with data tools. And by the way, do not download Visual Studio. Visual Studio is not a free product. Visual Studio is what we are using, but a miniature version of Visual Studio with templates for these things. So what you want to download is the data tools, not Visual Studio. It will download Visual Studio automatically, but that's a miniature version, that's not a full version. Full version of Visual Studio is not a free product. Okay? So now we are starting on chapter 15. So you do one other thing, guys. View, start page, and if you really want to clean things up, you go here and remove this. This removing does not delete. Keep in mind, This is just removing the list from the recent list. This is not deleting, okay? And now open a project and then go to what is it, class, chapter 5, Adventure Works, and open this guy. And what happens here? There are a few things you need to keep in mind, guys. What is the problem here? This is version 2008. So it is telling us that it is going to upgrade it to 2016, okay? So click OK here and let it upgrade it. If there is an error here, things won't work. Is there any error here?
No.
No, so it'll work. Don't worry about warnings. So everything has worked. Warnings, messages, don't worry. Now, if you go to solution, do you see we have product dimension, we have date dimension, we have employee dimension. Do you see that?
Yeah.
So your midterm cube design will be very, very simple. Final exam will be slightly more complicated, not that much more. Okay? Slightly more complicated. Anyway, so this is the end of chapter 4. Now what you can do is you can deploy it. Now if you see here, watch here guys, let me show it to you because it is good to learn. If you go to chapter 5 here, chapter 5 in class, if you look at Adventure Works, what is this backup is the old version, don't worry about it. If you see here, do you see this bin and object? Do you see this bin and object? These are the compiled version. When you build, it will create those. I can delete it, watch. I can delete them. Because this is my design. The bin and object folders were the compiled version. When you do the build, it does that. Let me show it to you, watch. I'm going to go here, okay? And do you see there is a choice called build? Build will not deploy it, it will not deploy. It will create compiled versions. Watch. Build. And of course, if it doesn't succeed, there is a problem. It succeeded, do you see that? Now if you go back to your folder, where is that? Do you see you have it? So these two guys are the compiled version and these are all XML files. And they are pretty obvious. What is this? This is the date dimension. And all of these are XML files, guys. You can open them in Notepad. What? Open with Notepad. Here. Everything is XML. Okay? So these are dimensions. Okay? What is this?
Data
source. What is this?
Data.
View. And these are the user settings, default settings. Okay? And this is the project. This is your actual database. Any definition that you created is in that one. And when you build, it gets deployed. It gets compiled. Okay? Clear? I will be repeating some of these things to help you understand. Now, I can go here and I can go to deploy. And if the deployment has an error, stop. You have to fix that problem. It failed. Can you tell me why? You should know it.
We have to refresh the data source.
What?
We have to refresh the data source and select local.
Yes, you are right. Let me tell you what the problem is. I intentionally did this. See, this is old version, okay? And the old version uses Microsoft SQL Server client version 10. And we are using client version 11,
yeah.
And 10 is not there. That is the problem, okay? This is because we are converting from the old version. If you start from scratch, you won't have this problem. So what you do is this. You go to data source. This guy. Okay? Now, do you see this is client end? Native client end, do you see that? Provider is, see, your machine, your application can connect to the server using client, native client. And that is version 10, which we don't have here. So you have to change this. And to do that, click on edit, okay? And go to the bottom, there is version 11 here. Native client 11, do you see that? Now you can test, now you have to specify database and other things. Your server could be local host. In Office, it will be the name of the server machine. Okay, and your database will be this guy. And you should test connection, because if the connection is not working, you can't work. Click OK. Click OK. And now if you deploy it, see, there is another clue that you have. If you go here and you click on any of these tables and you click on explore data, if the connection was not proper, you won't be able to see the data. Am I right? See, if you had client problem, you won't see this. It will give you an error because it is getting the data from the source tables. Okay? So this is another clue. Anyway, now if you deploy it, it will work. Now if you go to the management studio, watch here guys, there is no database there. AdventureWorks came. Where did it come from? Anyway, let me delete it. It should not have been there. I don't know where it came from. I must have done something that brought it. Now if I click on deploy, that will bring the, that will do that compilation again. It will clear those two folders again, overwrite them, and then it will deploy it. Now it is successful.
Yeah.
And now if you see it here,
you need to connect.
You will see the database. What is the problem? I don't see it.
Refresh.
You have to refresh, right? Guys, I'm not going to hold anything against any of you. I'm going to try to help you, but you have to prove to me that you are trying. That's what I'm looking for, okay? Even if you don't do so well in the test, I'll probably give you at least a B or B minus. As long as you prove to me that you are working. Anyway, now watch here, guys. Do you see you have data source here? Do you see you have view here? Do you see you have a cube here? There's no cube because it is chapter 4. It is end of chapter 4. Chapter 5 is the cube. We don't have it. So this is the end of chapter 4, so there's no cube. And do you see we have three dimensions?
Yeah.
Guys, data mining is a little advanced and really very, very useful. I may not be able to do hands-on in this class, I don't know, because that takes some effort and that is a little advanced, but I'll definitely talk about it, and it is something worthwhile that you should learn, okay? Because that is the next step. After learning cube design, next step is to learn data mining. But I will definitely talk about it. Okay, so are we all there? Are we all together here? So let's get started. I'm starting with chapter 5. And I'm going to go very, very slow. Guys, nobody's eating these things. What is the problem? Do you guys have dietary problem like me or what? We have a major Indian festival, as you know, Diwali. We
so
share
no
sweets.
So no classes this week. No classes this week.
What did you say?
No classes, right?
No classes?
Yeah.
You wish.
Well, let me tell you. On the day of the Diwali, we have to work. If you are working for an American company.
What is that?
It's called Festival of Lights. It's a major festival in India like Christmas. And we exchange a lot of sweet and eat a lot of sweet. So
when I was in Bangalore, when I was going for the first time again, I had my exam on the Diwali. Final exam.
Well, in India that is rare because they probably give you off.
No, because Bangalore people, they don't celebrate.
Because it has become westernized or what? So guys, I'm repeating it again. 3, 4, 5. Make sure you do it once, twice, thrice, four times till you get it right. Because if you don't, then trust me, you will not be able to do well in midterm as well as final. Okay? Midterm is a very, very simple cube. Final will be slightly more complex cube, but it is all about designing cube. See, these days I'm not allowed to eat sweet, so I have diabetes. You guys can finish it up. I wanted to get samosa, but that is messy. Somebody has to heat it up and it is oily and all that stuff.
Yeah, shortbread is good.
Salt is.
Yeah, it's all sweet.
Yeah.
Sugar. And those of you who are on my Thursday class, you will get it again. Okay guys, let's get started now.
Page 102. No.
Okay, let me ask you a few questions that are pertinent while you are eating. What is a dimension?
Dimension is a table that comes from data warehouse, our labels.
What role does it play in your cube?
Our label, our descriptions.
It provides descriptive level,
yeah,
by which you are summarizing your numbers.
Yeah.
And numbers are called measures, am I right?
Yeah. Measures are numbers.
Okay, so I'm going to next page. Guys, read between lines. I have about 100 questions that I have ready now. All true, false. They are all from your book, and those are the ones I'm going to use. Okay? So if you read between the lines, you will be able to do very well. Okay. Now guys, now let's go back. I'm done with the management studio. So let's go back. Now I have this guy. Now, this is the view, am I right? And these, what are these? These are just different diagrams for your big view. They are subset of tables. If you make a change in, let's say, in this reseller sales dimension, diagram, if you make a change in one of these tables, will it be reflected in other diagrams that have that table? Yes.
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 We are in the same
because project. If you make a change, you are changing your view. And these diagrams are nothing but a different window on the same original view. So this is your main view.
But on the other hand,
this is your main view. Other views are just subsets of this. So any change you make in any table, in any of the diagram, will be reflected here or in any other.
Excuse me, but on the other hand, this is dimension table. You can use dimension table in different projects.
That I am coming. Now there is another complication that is going to happen that he is talking about. What are these? These are dimensions, but they are not cube dimensions. You will see today when we design our cube, it will also have these dimensions coming from here. But those are cube dimensions. So I'll explain that in a minute, okay? So let's move on, okay? Using the wizard to create a cube. That is, I am going to do page number 105. Okay?
Yeah.
So let's close the view. Right click cubes folder. We are designing our cube. Right click cubes folder. New cube. We are doing a new cube. And this is the wizard. Okay?
Yeah.
Click on next. We are going to use existing tables, am I right?
Yeah.
And by the way, there is an important item here. If you are creating a dimension called date, remember I told you relational databases typically do not have date table?
Yeah.
They have order date, sync date, request date, all the dates, but they do not have a separate date table. And just about every cube has a date dimension. Because that is one of the most important items that executives use. Sales by quarter, sales by month, sales by year. And those are dates, okay? So if you want to create, and I'm going to show it to you, if you want to create a date dimension, you can do that using your existing system, and I'm going to show that to you. But for now, we are going to use existing table to create a cube. You can also create an empty cube and then start adding dimensions and measures. You can do that too, okay? Manually. But we are going to use what the book is.
Easy way or it's tricky?
Once you know it, it is very easy.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to be good at it, okay?
Okay.
Adding dimensions is very simple, just drag and drop.
But we need to know the logic of...
Yeah, you need to understand all those things. Okay, so we are going to use existing tables, okay?
Next.
Now the first question is, select measure groups. A cube consists of measures and dimensions. Dimensions we have already designed. We are going to use them. Measures we have not designed because measures are always part of the cube. Dimensions are not part, actually, the dimensions that we designed, we can use them in three different cubes. Okay?
Yes.
So they are really independent of cube. But they will go into cube once you add them. Anyway, measures are based on numeric tables, which are typically called what? Fact tables. Okay?
Yeah.
So we are going to pick which tables measures are going to be coming from. Fact reseller sales, fact sales. Fact reseller sales, fact internet sales. Guys, if I make a mistake, let me know.
Yeah.
Product forecast. Which one is that? This one? Three of them, am I right?
Yeah.
So we are going to use these three. Of course, dimension table are not used for creating measures. Now, each one of these fact table will create what is known as a measure group. And the numbers that you pick from those tables will be the number that you are summarizing in your cube. So you don't pick every number. Like fact table has an ID called product ID. You don't summarize product IDs. So you will not use that in your measure, okay? So click on next. Now fact reseller sales. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now,
clear all the measures.
Clearing the measure checkbox clears all of the. So we are going to clear everything.
Yeah.
How do you clear everything?
Uncheck.
That will clear everything. Now we are going to pick a few of them and tell me what are they.
But we have a message. At least one measure group must be selected.
what is the message here? You have to have at least one number that you are summarizing, otherwise there is no point, am I right?
Yeah.
So what are we picking here, guys? Help me.
Order
quantity.
And
we are picking, where is that? Order quantity, I can't see it. Order quantity.
Yes.
And sales amount.
Yes.
Is that the one? Order quantity and sales amount.
Yeah,
the message has disappeared. You see that? Read between the lines, guys, because I am picking up all your test questions from this book. Okay? I may ask you, as an example, if no columns are selected from fact table, will there be some kind of a message?
Yes.
Yes. Will that message disappear as soon as you select one of the columns?
Yes.
Those are the kind of true false, all true false. So we did that, okay? Now let's go to the next one.
A way to select dimensions.
We missed one of the tables. What happened?
We have to do it for three columns.
What?
We need to go to select for all the tables.
Let's go back. We selected internet sales also, am I right?
Yes, so we have to select.
So we selected these two.
Now we have to scroll down and select.
Scroll down to the back. Yes, go back because we have to select a few more.
Yeah, we have selected.
As soon as you select one measure,
sales
in the fact internet sales, select order quantity.
No, the table on 0.7 and 0.9
is
different.
1% at a time, please. 1%.
The table on 0.7 and 0.9 is totally different. It's the first half and second half.
You mean like, at first we selected two things. Can you go to back? We just selected from one. We need to select from fact engineering.
Select existing dimension.
Back.
We will select all the dimension, okay?
No.
Back.
Yeah,
scroll down,
Oh, everything
we
is here.
Selected
okay.
From
okay, I missed that.
Yeah.
I'm glad you guys are awake.
Hey, sir.
So
yes.
We get rid of this also?
Yes.
And what do we select here?
Order
quantity. And
sales amount.
And then what do we select from the third one?
Sales amount
forecast.
Yes.
That's all we take, am I right?
Yeah.
Click on next. Now each of these fact table will create its own measure group. And in that group, the columns that we picked will be our measures. And of course, you don't pick like product ID or customer ID. You don't summarize them. You pick like sales amount, shipping amount, tax amount, all those numbers that you want to summarize. Okay? And we'll pick all the dimensions. So I'll leave it as that's what we are doing, am I right? That is step number 11. We have all three of them.
Yeah.
Now we do next. And what is this? This is advanced stuff. We are going to do that later on. You can also create dimensions from fact table, some advanced dimensions. That is chapter number 6. Okay? Right now we are not going to do that. If you want to create dimensions from fact tables, you can do that. In certain situations, you have to do it. But that's advanced, so we are not going to work with that. So let's deselect all of that. Is that what the book is doing?
Yeah.
Good. Next. Now, it gives you to review it. And what is the name of the cube?
Adventure Works.
Change the name of the cube to Adventure Works without space. capital WRUs. Okay, this is the cube. Next. Now this is very interesting, guys. If you see factory seller sales table, we have two measures. These are the numbers that you want to summarize by various dimensions. Okay? Now internet sales, no employees are involved because that is direct sale. And watch the dimensions, guys, watch here. Now things are going to get slightly more involved, okay? These are cube dimensions. And these are database dimensions. And database dimension does not mean relational database. It means your multi-dimensional analysis services database. So these are the dimensions in the database itself. And what you have done is you have brought them into here. Okay? Now these dimensions are really, at this point, reflection of these dimensions. But you can rename them. Okay? And there's another interesting thing here. You have only one date dimension. How many date dimensions you have here?
Many.
Four. Ship date, order date, due date. And you have date. SQL Server recognizes that executive might want to summarize sales by ship year or sales by order year, okay, or by due year, because those columns are there, am I right? Executive might want to see from any of them, but those are all date related, am I right? So even though you have only one dimension called date, it turned into three or four dimensions there, one for each of the date key, and SQL Server does that automatically. These are called role-playing dimension, because this dimension is playing the role of these three cube dimensions, four cube dimensions. It's playing the role. It's the same dimension, but it has different incarnations in your cube. Okay? That is role-playing. Now, you can change the names here without affecting those guys. And there's another interesting thing, watch. If you look at internet sales, do you see order quantity has a slightly different name? Do you see that? Because two measures, no matter which group they are in, cannot have the same name. See, order quantity is there and here as well. Do you see that?
Yeah.
So it automatically gave the name order quantity fact internet sales, just to give it different name. Okay? Because two measures cannot have the same name. And by the way, measures are numbers, but when you talk about MDX, which we will be doing today, later on, measure is like a dimension also. So measure is just another numeric dimension. Of course, the difference between measure dimension and your dimension is that your dimensions have attribute, each attribute has two levels, all and select distinct. Measure dimension doesn't have levels. It just has one item. Okay? Clear? Now, let's save our work. I don't want to jump, and I have a tendency to jump. Okay, now watch here. There is dimension usage. What is this? It tells you how is fact reseller sales measure is connected to these dimensions. Okay? And if you see here, internet cell, employee is empty. Do you see that? Can you tell me why?
Because we do.
Because employees are not selling anything. It's that internet sale is direct sale. Employees don't sell anything there. That is why there is no relationship, no connection. Okay? Okay, now what we are going to do is, let me see. Step number 4, select the cell in the grid at the intersection of date and factory seller sales measure. Where does it change the name? It changes the name somewhere in the book. Let me see if it does it later on. Guys, do you see where does it changes the name of the measures? Review the structure. We are there. What? Which page number? It changes the names. What is the page number? Where does it change the name? I don't see it.
I don't think it's in this chapter.
It will change it somewhere. It will change it. Oh, adding user friendly name, page number 122. So, I just don't want to miss something, guys, because I have a tendency to miss and jump. Anyway, select the grid, intersection of date, order date. Select order date, date, order date, and fact reseller sales. Fact reseller sales. Do you see this dot dot dot?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Click here. It tells you what is the relationship. It tells you it is a regular type of relationship. Granularity is the level at which you are looking, granularity, like at the day level or at the hour level or at the minute level. We are looking at the day level. That is the lowest level. Okay? Granularity. If you are analyzing stock market, you might look at every minute. Okay? We are looking every day. Now, do you see? Granularity is day, every day.
Yeah.
Do you see it is this dimension is coming from
date.
A table called dim date, and measure is coming from fact reseller sales. And how are they related? There is a date key.
And order date key.
And there is an order date key. This is the key, date key in dimension. And this is the key in
measure.
Okay?
Yeah.
What kind of relationship is this?
One to many.
One to many. For every date there are many sales. Am I right?
Yeah.
Agreed? In date dimension, if your granularity is date, then, remember I told you in the dimension it is select distinct?
Yeah.
Remember that? So each day will be selected, am I right? So in your date dimension, there is a row for each date, agreed? That is one row for each date. And for that row, there are many rows in the sales because you have made many sales on that date. So it is one to many, am I right?
Yes.
That is the regular, okay? And we'll talk about other things later on. There is more here. And this is the picture you see. Okay? One to many. And Microsoft always goes from many to one. But this is one to many relationship. Now the book says, repeat step at the intersection of date and fact internet sales. Date and fact internet sales. Same thing. this time your sales are coming from internet sales table, okay? But it is one to many relationship. Do you see that? Clear?
Yeah.
Any questions? So in your date dimension, that will show you how to build. And if your granularity is one day, one date, there should be one row for each date, am I right? Not two rows. Okay, same thing it says. Date in fact, product date. Now this is interesting. That was step number three. Okay? Step number five. Date in fact, date in fact. What is this watch? This is little different.
Granularity is month.
Now, in the product forecast table, your granularity is not day. You are not forecasting for every day. You are forecasting for every month. That is how your table is built. Okay? In your company, that is how the table is built. Forecasting by every day doesn't make sense. Forecast numbers are just assumptions anyway. Those are just estimates. Am I right? So you don't want to forecast. So if you see here, it is on month.
Or maybe we can have forecasting by 6 months or...
You can have forecasting by quarter. It
yes.
depends. Forecasting you can do by quarter.
Yeah.
Companies do that. But this company is doing forecasting by month. That's what it is.
So what is the message came?
Basic.
What it is saying is, because the granularity here is different, it's a month key,
yeah.
You have to make sure to be able to aggregate with that one, there is a relationship established. That is the attribute relationship. And I'll come to that. Right now, you only need to be concerned with granularity here is at the month level, not at the day. Okay? I think that is it. Now, let's deploy the cube and the fun begins. Okay? And everything changes here. Microsoft has changed everything here. At the moment, I can just deploy here. Build, deploy. And if there is no error, you are in good shape. And this is what you will do in your midterm as well as in your final. If there is an error here, first you need to check your dimensions, they are correct. And each dimension you can deploy to make sure they are correct. And then you build the cube and deploy. And if it's a problem, it is probably in the measure, not in the dimension, okay?
Yes.
Deployment is successful.
Yeah.
Okay? Now watch. I'm going to the browser. Okay? This browser is not the same as what you have in the book. Microsoft took away the browser that looks like what you have in the book because they want to sell Excel. Okay? Now, you have to reconnect, am I right?
Yeah.
You have to reconnect, agreed? So let's reconnect. Now, watch here, I want to show you something. Internet sales. Where is internet sales? Order quantity. This is the total sales. Total sales from that internet sales table. I want to do sales by employee. Where is employee dimension? What is this? If you get this, what does it mean? All the numbers are the same. That means there is no relationship between this dimension and this measure. And here it is very obvious. Because internet sales are direct sales, employees are not selling. Those sales are not attributed to employees' efforts. Am I right? So if you see the same number, that means there is a problem in the relationship. There is no relationship. Okay?
Excuse me, how can we end in the query this employee and order quantity, drag and drop?
What? You can drag and drop. Watch here.
Okay.
Right click it, click on clear grid. Clear, okay?
Yeah.
Clear grid. Now you can take employee and put it here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now before you do that, you have to put numbers. Otherwise it won't come up. Okay?
Yeah.
Now this browser.
You okay?
Yeah.
This browser is good enough. This browser is good enough for developers. Because when you're doing development work, you just need to make sure everything is working. But this browser is lousy. Okay? Watch. What is the problem here? Watch. I'm going to clear the grid. Okay? I am going to go to product dimension. Where is product? I have a user defined hierarchy. Do you see that?
Yeah.
And I'm going to go to
order.
I'm going to go to sales. Reseller sales. Order amount. Sales amount. This is the total sales. Okay?
Yeah.
And I'm going to see the sales by product category. This is hierarchy. Watch. This is lousy. I will show you the same thing. It used to look very, very different what you see in the book. But what you see in the book, now you can see in Excel. Okay? Microsoft took away that browser. That was like Excel. That is in your book. But it is good enough to see your numbers and to see everything is working. Okay? Now what I'm going to do here is clear this and I'm going to go to Excel. Where is Excel this time? Do you see Excel? I'll go to Excel. We'll take a break in 5 minutes, okay? Let me just show it to you.
I cannot see this. Oh, I see. Yeah.
Now we are going to enable whatever it message it says about security. And now watch. Now I'm just going to show you quickly how this works here, okay? I want sales amount. Where will sales amount go? Values, am I right?
Yeah.
Because it's a number, agreed? Do you see that? And I want product. Where is product? I want to drag product in rows. Now this makes a lot more sense, am I right?
Yeah.
Do you see it? This is how your browser was. I will not ask you any advanced question. This is pivot table. That's all it is. Now watch here. If you go to design tab, if you go to pivot table, and if you go to options, and if you go to display, say show items with no data on rows. So items with no data on rows. What does it do? Watch. If there are no sales, it will show you that also. Empty rows, it will show you. At the moment, let me leave it out. I'll show that to you a little later. It will show you empty rows. Okay?
Display.
Let me show you something else here. Go to design tab, report layout, This is all pivot table. It's common sense. You don't need anything advanced, but if you really want to become good at it, it is worth it. Guys, today, Excel is used more all over the world than anything else. You won't believe, you don't even have to learn analysis services to do simple cubes. You can do it in Excel, and I'm going to demo it to you. It's very simple. Of course, it is not as powerful as what we can do in multi-dimensional. That is called tabular modeling. It's something new, okay? But you can do it in Excel in few steps. Not only that, you can do data mining in Excel too. So Excel has become an extremely powerful tool. It is called personal BI, personal business intelligence. It is for end user business intelligence. People who are a little more technical, who understand these things a little bit more, they can do it right over here without knowing analysis services. For day-to-day work, okay? But watch here. Report, outline format, okay? Report, tabular form. This is tabular form. Report, compact form. In compact form, everything is looking in column A. Do you see that? If you go to report outline form, it is column ABC. So, you know, play with it and you will see what I mean. Okay? Any questions? In your test, I may ask you some basic question. What feature of Excel is used to view your cube data? That is a pivot table feature. I may ask you that, but I won't ask you anything more than how does this work in pivot table, how does that work. That is a pivot table course, and you don't have to buy the book. There are plenty of material available on the internet in PDF form, and you can use that to learn a little bit more about pivot table. For this course, I don't care. Okay? Any questions? So this browser looks more like your, what you see in your book, okay? So browsing the cube, all these pictures won't make sense because that is old stuff and Microsoft took it away in 2012. It was there in 2008, they took it away in 2012. And they said that if you want to see from the user perspective, use Excel. Okay? Any questions? Now there is a couple of other things I want to show you. This is something interesting and then we'll take a break, okay? Now watch here, guys. Filter. I want to filter data. So let me say calendar. I want to filter on calendar year. Okay?
Same as pivot table in Excel.
It's a pivot table.
This is the pivot table.
Calendar date.
Right.
This is pivot table.
Yeah. Now watch. I want to see only 2010 data. Watch. I want to see just 2010.
Select multiple.
At the moment, I'm selecting only one. This is 2010 numbers.
Yeah.
If I want 2010 and 11. Select two of them. This is 10 and 11. Something very interesting, watch guys. I'm going to remove the filter, okay? I will select all. And I'm going to remove the filter. How do I remove the filter? There are a number of ways. Gone. Now there's something very, very interesting that I really like. Let me show that to you. That is called slicer, okay? There is something called slicer here. Now, where is it? Let me find. Guys, help me out. Where is slicer here? don't remember these things, guys. Analyze. Insert slicer. Do you see this?
Yeah.
Insert slicer. See, you don't have to memorize these things. You just play with it. I don't use pivot table every day. So I don't remember any of this. And I'm going to put a slicer on fiscal here. No, calendar here. Let me stick to calendar. Slicer is nothing but filter. But now it is more visual, okay? Now if you want to pick 2010, I just click here and press enter key. It is 2010 data. Okay? If I pick two of these, press enter key, I'm looking at
2010 and 2011.
8, 9, 10, 11. Okay? It will look better if I go this way. So slicer is nothing but a filter, okay? Numbers should be changing. Why aren't they changing? You see numbers 663?
Yeah.
See this number? You have to press enter key.
And press double enter. Let double click.
Some row number is changing.
Numbers should change. This filter means this is clear filter, okay? Now if I want to select filter, let me pick 2011. Now it should change the number. This is 804, am I right? Slicer is nothing but a filter, it should change, I don't know why it's not changing. Sales amount should change still. Let me put calendar.
No, yeah.
By the way, how do I get my that item there?
By clicking on the left on that shape.
Here?
Yes. And then you have to bring calendar here into the filter from the pivot table.
Okay, let's bring the calendar here. Now how do I get this? Watch here, guys, this is important. It disappeared. You see that? If I click inside, it will appear. Now let me get calendar here in the columns. Calendar here in the columns. Okay?
No, not in the column.
The filter. Now if I remove the filter, numbers should change.
No, we have to bring it into the filter.
Into the filter, not into the columns.
You have to bring it into the filter also?
Yes.
But then what is the point of slicer?
No, slicer will change it. Yes, now it will change. Now it will change.
Okay, okay. See how much I know about pivot tables? Now you know, you can be safe that I won't ask you this question. Okay? Yeah, but it still doesn't make sense to me. Slicer is filter.
Maybe that calendar.
In fact, we cannot apply filter.
It is changing on my
filter.
Are you changing on my?
Why is it changing on my machine? See, you don't need this filter. You don't need this. Okay, you don't need this. The whole idea behind slicer is. Just pick these numbers and press enter key and you should change the numbers.
Maybe you bought fiscal day and on the one side it is the other day, because in the shipment day we have calendar date and fiscal date. So when you created the slicer, did you create it on fiscal year or it's calendar year?
It's calendar year.
And you have to bring filter also in calendar.
But doesn't make sense because we need
filter
to,
is the
we
same
need to
thing
have
as slicer.
A report for.
Yeah, but you have to bring it in the filter.
And the filter, then it will work. Yeah.
try to change now.
I'll try to change.
I'm going to change it here, okay?
Maybe you need to create the
I'm going to clear the filter.
You have to change the filter. You have to clear the filter.
Do you see I cannot change it?
No, you have to create the slicer again and maybe it will work. Cancel the slicer.
Cut.
Now
that is the filter, okay? Slicer is nothing but a filter.
Yes, so now we need to recreate the slicer and add.
Let me bring the slicer again. Calendar here.
Is that calendar here the same as shipment date dot calendar here?
Yes.
No, in the slicer.
Oh, yes, you have to be sure that
you
say ship date.
Let me delete it.
You're going to crash with this one.
Okay, let me do slicer.
Slowly. Now let's move to the
scroll
shipment.
Scroll down to
shipment. Scroll down.
Oh, okay, I know what the problem is. Thank you.
Right.
See, this is the problem.
So it should be shipment date dot calendar date.
Where is shipment date?
Yes.
Yeah.
Shipment
calendar
date.
Year.
This should be the year.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now.
Now
it changed.
Now let me remove this thing, because slicer is the same as filter, okay? You don't need filter separately. See, now it is changing, do you see that? You don't need filter. Slicer is filter, but it is visual, okay? See, I was picking the wrong data. Do you see this? Filter and slicer are really two different faces of the same item, that is filtering the data. In filter, you have drop down and you pick what you want. In slicer, all your possible items are available in that your box. And you pick and choose from here. Okay, see that? I was picking the wrong here. Okay? Any questions? Any questions? Okay, let's take a break now, 15 minutes. And again, guys, I'm repeating. 3, 4, 5. 3 is the easy chapter. All you have to do is define the data source and the data source view and make some changes in your view, like replace a table with a query, change the names, etc., and set up a relationship where it doesn't exist. 4 is really defining dimensions, and 5 is really creating the cube. Okay? 15 minute break, please come back in 15 minutes.